Eight Swords of India. So let us take a glimpse of all our legends, the untold story. East or West, India is the best. East or West, India is the best. So marching forward are all the famous empires, legends of India. Is often referred as God's own country. This beautiful land is rightly called the paradise, given to its lush, green scenic landscape and crystal clear features that will leave you awestruck. Blessed with natural beauty and ecological diversity, Kerala has lot to offer tourists and travelers. If you haven't visited Kerala already, you must start planning a trip right away. Beautiful state Kerala by the students of grade 4.
India has traditionally been the home of different cultures and people. Unity in diversity is one of the most prominent features in the people of India. Among the diversified population, a significant role is comprised of the tribal people. We is the Abos from Arunachal Pradesh, Bhutias from Garhwal and Kamya region, Khasi from Assam and the Kota from Tamil Nadu. Indian tribal people play a very important role constructing the cultural heritage of India.
So here we have fascinating, vibrant and colorful grade 6 parading before you. Goa is the smallest state of India. It has a great contribution towards India's economy. Come on, audience, let us cheer for the fun-loving girl. I did not want to miss out the match between India and Pakistan. So you are so passionate about cricket, it seems.
Yes, I am. Cricket and life are alike. Every ball equals every minute. Every shot equals an opportunity. And every wicket is an obstacle. Cricket, cricket, cricket. It is everywhere. Listen to Young India Talking and you will find the conversation centered only on cricket. Especially when India is playing a cricket match. Cricket has become every youngster's dream. Cricket has become a religion. So here we have the grade 7 parading before us to keep the spirit of the game alive.
history of different communities belonging to different religions. So almost every day, we see a festival being celebrated with great joy and fun. Be it Deepavali, Eid ul-Fitr, Christmas, Mahavir Jayanti or Buddha Jayanti. These festivals are celebrated without any ill will or communal hatred. Festivals promote the feeling of communal harmony. Yes, it is very much true that during festivals, the unity and integrity of India increases and the bond of friendship between communities increases manifold. Hear from the students of grade 8 to spread a feeling of oneness among us. These are mainly due to substance abuses. The picture is grim if the world statistics on the drug scenario is taken into account. Millions of drug addicts all over the world are leading miserable lives between life and death. Effective substance abuse prevention is everyone's responsibility. So let us join our hands to fight against this menace. Our students of grade 9 exhibit the ill effects of drug abuse.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, dignitaries, invited guests, respected principal sir, brothers, teachers, parents, and my dearest students. Today on this very special occasion of our nation's Republic Day and our school's annual day celebration, we, the Parent Teacher Association, are greatly pleasured and thankful to present in front of you a short life story of our highly respected and beloved former President of India, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. To be named as Abul Pakir Jainuddin Abdul Kalam, better known as Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Mr. Kalam was born in a Tamil Muslim family in the pilgrimage center of Rameshwaram in the state of Tamil Nadu. His mother, Ashiyamma, was a housewife. Mr. Kalam's father, Jainuddin, was a boat owner an imam of a local mosque, who also owned a ferry that took pilgrims back and forth between Rameshwaram and the now uninhabited Dhanushkodi. Mr. Kalam was the youngest of four brothers and one sister in his family. By his early childhood, his family had become poor. At an early age, Mr. Kalam sold newspapers to supplement his family's income. In his school years, Mr. Kalam was described as a bright and hard-working student who had a strong desire to learn. He spent hours on his studies, especially mathematics. After completing his initial education, Mr. Kalam studied aerospace engineering in Madras Institute of Technology. He narrowly missed achieving his dream of becoming a fighter pilot. After graduating from the Madras Institute of Technology in 1960, he joined the Aeronautical Development Establishment of the Defense Research and Development Organization as a scientist after becoming a member of the Defense Research and Development Service, DRDS. In 1969, Mr. Kalam was transferred to the Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO, where he was the project director of India's first satellite launch vehicle, SLV-3, which successfully deployed the Rohini satellite. He served as the chief scientific advisor to the Prime Minister and the Secretary of Defense Research and Development Organization from July 1992 to December 1999. He was known as the Missile Man of India. According to history, his association with cardiologist Soma Raju, Mr. Kalam developed a low-cost coronary stent named the Kalam Raju stent. The Pokhran 2 nuclear tests were conducted during this period, in which Mr. Kalam played an intensive political and technological role. Mr. Kalam served as the chief project coordinator along with Rajagopala Chidambaram during the testing phase. This made him the best known nuclear scientist of India. Wings of Fire, an autobiography of APJ Abdul Kalam, was written by Mr. Kalam and Arun Tiwari. In it, Mr. Kalam examines his early life, effort, hardship, fortitude, love, and chance that eventually led him to lead Indian space research, nuclear and missile programs. Dr. Kalam served as the 11th president of India. He won the 2002 presidential election with a massive electoral vote of 922,884, surpassing the 107,366 votes won by Lakshmi Sehgal. He was the third president of India to have been honored with a Bharat Ratna, India's highest civilian honor, before becoming the president. During his term as president, he was affectionately known as the People's President. His term lasted from July 25, 2002 to July 25, 2007. After leaving office, Mr. Mr. Kalam became a visiting professor at the Indian Institute of Management Shillong, the Indian Institute of Management Ahmedabad, and the Indian Institute of Management Indore, an honorary fellow of Indian Institute of Science Bangalore, Chancellor of the Indian Institute of Space Science and Technology Thiruvananthapuram, Professor of Aerospace Engineering at Anna University, and an adjunct at many other academic and research institutions across India. He taught information technology at the International Institute of Information Technology, Hyderabad, and technology at Banaras Hindu University and Anna University. Dr. Kalam was an epitome of exemplary high life values and most appropriately called Missile Man of India. Ek salam to Dr. Kalam. Thank you and good day to all.